Well, meanwhile, Missouri Congressman Ike Skelton, one of just 39 Democrats to vote against the health care bill last year, says he's still against it. Michael Mahoney spoke to him today before headed back to Washington. Michael?
Well, we're in front of Truman Medical Center because this is an element of the story. There are a lot of folks from rural Missouri and Kansas on Medicare that eventually come here to TMC. Now, Skelton says that this is going to be a very, very close vote, as Sally indicated in her report. But he says, despite the fact that it's going to be so close, he has received very little pressure from either congressional leadership or the White House to switch his vote.
I've gotten one call. That was from the Secretary of Agriculture.
And what did the secretary tell you or ask of you?
He wanted to know if I could see my way clear and vote for it. I said, no, I couldn't.
Say ah.
Skelton and many in rural medicine don't like this health care bill because it takes more than $200 billion away from Medicare, alarming many rural health clinics and hospitals.
Many of your rural hospitals, your small town hospitals, are dependent upon Medicare patients. And I think that would lead to some of them closing down.
Now, Skelton says there's a need for health care reform, but he calls the current plan a bad bill.
There are many issues in health care that nearly every one of us can agree on and make that a basis for future discussion.
So do it step by step.
Absolutely.
A new poll from voters in swing districts, many full of small towns like Skelton's region, shows a plurality of voters in those districts agree with that start-from-scratch approach. That poll has another result that Skelton, who is facing one of the toughest re-election fights of his long career, may find interesting. The survey shows a Democrat like Skelton, who serves a politically conservative district like his and who voted against health care the first time, would benefit politically the most of all members of Congress by voting against it a second time.
Now, Skelton says, and Sally Kidd intimated this in her report, there are actually probably two big health care votes coming down the pike. The one that is on the table in the House now, where they're essentially voting on the Senate version of the bill. Then there will be a second one a little bit later on, where that will be the reconciliation bill that Sally referred to in her report. So two more big health care votes coming, and Ike Skelton says he won't be moved by it. He's staying with his no vote. We're live at Truman Medical. Back to you.